and she's starting to enjoy showing off. But John just lets her have freely at the moment, all play and find little dummies and things hidden. So things are being found close to him. So then when she starts to focus on him, and this is my mentality, you see, that's a great play. But don't worry about it. Call her in, make a big fuss, don't snatch the dummy off of her, because what we want to do is encourage the dog to be gentle with her mouth as well. We don't want her to down his game in the future. These dogs, we must say, are usually very, very kind and mouth, very gentle, so that's
not useful.
Now, as you can see with Isla, she's a lemon and white. They come in different colours. You have orange and white and lemon and white. And we're trying to really get back to those lovely Victorian printed paintings when you look at the dogs on those, which actually had quite a bit of colour. And also have that lovely little fitting spot on the top of the head, which I'm very pleased to say is coming through a lot of the luck. As you can see, she's agile. People like to think clumbers are slow and lumbering type sort of dogs. Well, not the working type. They're a dog that can work all day. They have a good taste, good style. And usually, they're a bit more methodical when they're hunting, a bit slower than a clumber or a sprinter. But actually, when you're hunting for a straight line, and they're out with my sprinters or our poppers, I have to say, they keep up when they're coming in a straight line to you. But as you can see, it's just all let them run in, play, have fun. It makes no difference what it is that she's feeling with. Just anything and everything. So that's a good sign. But this little girl is something that John hopes that maybe in the future he may be able to trial. Who knows? We'll have to wait and see. But she will have a great deal of experience in the scented ground. You need scented ground to get these dogs going, really. If you're finding your training becoming a bit boring and stale, then you need to move to more interesting scented ground.
Breed and hunting is what they love to do most, so that side of things comes fairly naturally. Retrieving, well, it's something that they will do, but they have to have the pleasure and get the experience at a young age. Otherwise you may have a dog that starts to blink game and prefers to get into what it really enjoys, which is retrieving. So for an all-round dog, get this mastered first. So whether you're cutting wings off of dead birds or wrapping fur around tennis balls or whatever it may be, don't worry about it, whatever it gets it going at the beginning. Now that's little Isla. I think we'll put little Isla away now when she's finished. And we're going to have out another young dog. We're going to have Valerie out, actually, with her young Jazz. Now refresh my memory, how old Jazz is. 17 months. Now, Valerie is in quite a lucky position because she actually happens to be a keeper up at near Newbury. And so this little dog gets exposed to quite a bit of game at a young age. So Valerie also in the past has trialled springers and trialled clumbers, and she's had some success with one of the dogs we'll see in a while. So hopefully this little dog is something for the future. We shall see. A little hesitant being in here with all the goings on. But still happy enough to go out quickly on the retrieve there. Nice little pickup. I always think they're going to trip over those toggles. She's looking at the crowd, looking a little unsure to say, who are you lot? I'm not used to all this. I'm used to being on a nice private estate and working with my mum. But as you can see, a little older than Isla, so we've got a few little basics coming in here. A bit of steadiness. Dummy's being thrown for her. She's sitting there, having to wait. Three dummies being thrown out. And then Valerie will choose which one she's going for. Wants to go for the one behind her, the back. No problem at all. Just still looking at the rest of us. You're the little girl. You're a little Jazz. She said, but I fancy that one over there. No, not allowed. No. She's going to put her back into the centre position there where she was, so hopefully she's remembered her mark. Throw a distraction past her and then send her for the other one. Well, that's lovely for a young dog to show that control. Now, we're here for, well, this is our last day actually. We've been here since Friday. We're on the Sporting Dog, in the Sporting Dog Pavilion just behind me. And we have a stand, and we have various members. And we've been chatting to lots of people, got dreadful sore throat, I have to say. We chatted to lots of people about clumbers. And I think people have been a little surprised to see that these dogs are lean and fit and look like they can do a day's work. So we've got various people that now want to come and have a look at these dogs working in the field, so which would be nice. And hopefully from that we'll encourage some new members and hopefully some people to have some clumber spaniels. We have, as I said, a nine little things different in your kennel, and depending on the type of shooting you're doing, then that depends on the type of dog that you're bringing out. And as a rough shooting dog, they are a joy, because the pace that they're working at is a very nice pace when you're actually carrying a gun and doing a bit of walked up shooting. We've got Chris coming out now. Chris is coming out with Fel. Fel is a young dog. He is, I think he's about 11 months-ish, maybe, round about that. No, 9 months, there you go, even younger. And Chris, this is his second clumber now, and he seems to have got the bug, which is good. And Chris is actually quite lucky because he's in a wonderful area. He's up in Yorkshire, where there's lovely opportunities for rabbiting. And these dogs actually, when you get them working on rabbits, really start to get their hunting pattern in and get some nice style to them. Nice opportunity out of the shooting season to be able to work these dogs and get some retrieves. Well, coping very well with the ring. Letting him jump up, that doesn't matter. When you've got a young dog, especially a spaniel, if you've got them coming in with their retrieve and jumping up on you, So be it. You can soon push them back down later on when you've got the retrieve right. If you try and put that stop whistle, try and get them to sit too young, too soon in front of you with the presentation of the actual dummy, and it all starts to go wrong. Let him jump up and get covered in mud. Open Shaw was over there the other day doing his demo, and there he was, wrapped up in his boiler suit, and puppies climbing and jumping all over him. So just put your old clothes on, doesn't matter. Anyway, he's coping very well with his little retrieve down there. I think we're possibly, are we going to have one over the jumps in a minute? At the moment, there's something that needs working on there. His retrieves are coming back at some of the time, and they're just ending up on the ground. What you try to do is not actually pick the dummy up from the ground. Try and get the dog to always bring it up and into it. Start just rubbing it under the chest and chin, and try and get that head up and not accept the retrieve off the ground. Because if that was a wounded bird, then off it could run before it's in your hands. And this is at the end of the day what we're thinking of. We're thinking of being able to go out shooting with these dogs and work these dogs. So whether your shooting is from going out beating or picking up or just rough shooting or the odd driven day, then these dogs actually enjoy it all. And they do look good when we have the opportunities to get to somewhere like Yorkshire and Scotland on the heather and working them on the grouse moors. They do look rather lovely, as I had the opportunity last year. And these dogs also, I know there's dogs used in the West Country a lot of the time on some of the woodcock shoots down that way. And they do look good on that, and actually they have a fantastic nose. And sometimes when you're out, these dogs actually find that difficult bird that others haven't. Go with him if he's struggling. Just show him, Chris, he's only young. That's it, encourage him over. Love. Okay, that'll do you. That's wonderful. Now, I think we're going to have, where's John? There we go. This is Muffin. And Muffin is actually staying with us at the moment. Her owner's on holiday. And John said, can I pinch them and take them to the game fair? Anyway, they've only been with us a few days, and actually, they're lovely, thoroughly enjoying themselves. So this is Muffin, and Muffin, no. That wasn't meant to happen. Right, but we'll set that up differently, so John can throw the retrieve behind him, so he stands a chance of actually stopping her. So he's just learned a little something different about Muffin. Muffin yesterday, of course, did that perfectly, so he got a little bit confident on that. So we'll sit her down. He's going to throw the retrieve behind him. Make sure she just sits there for a minute. It's going to call her away from it. Sit up. And now we're going to send her forward. Lovely. see the speed that they're going at? Nice, fast retreat, coming all the way back. Slow on the way back, but not much. Now that's a heavier dog. So now this little girl, which belongs to Jane, this is one of her little foibles that she has with her. She doesn't always want to come right into Jane, but that's just one of those little habits that's developed with Jane and
Thank you.
because our members are scattered across the country. In fact, we do have members worldwide. We have members in Canada and members in Sweden as well, and Australia. But what we like to try and do is to put on various friendly events so people get to practice and train with their dogs with dummies or with cold games or having a live. That's her new owner, by the way, she's sitting on. I think we might just put her on the lead, John. And I think we'll just have Titus out for this one. I'm afraid she's just bad. She's
very nice estates across the country. And also we have days where we may be doing a bit more competition and field trials as well. But we just have to try and keep this all good fun and friendly and enjoyable, and really we want the dogs to become their own ambassadors and to show off and speak for themselves, which that's why we're doing this today here. Hold on a minute, I'm just going to get Titus out. This is difficult when you've got the mic.
Yes?
Not sure if you saw that, but we'll find out in a minute. Always keen to try and get it. I should have a game bag on, but I'm afraid I lost it to someone else. Hang on a minute, we'll just hand over this a little bit. As you can see, he's pulling to the little bits of cover that there are. He's going to bulldoze that. I'll just move down to Dave and see what we find down there. Come on, Titus. This dog actually is a dog that I trial. Ty. He's actually had a fourth and an AV running against Springers and Cockers. He's today. He's too busy finding other dogs. Rabbit, this side of the fence, I think. Yeah. Okay. Well, he's coming back and having this strike. Another one that likes to do a little lap of honour. I'll get the distraction. We'll just do a little one over the jumps and don't want him to miss out. And then we will be back on the stand today for you to be able to come and have a little chat with us. Dave's going to just throw me one over the jumps. Yep, we're going to have to work on that one, I think, for a little while, but anyway, we're here today with all the different dogs, so come and chat to us and come and find out more about clumbers if you wish, and maybe next time you're thinking of buying a spaniel instead of buying a springer or a cocker, maybe you'll have a clumber. Thank you.